The daily commute to work in the city could be contributing to the soaring rates of diabetes. New figures show Sydney's outer suburbs are increasingly at risk.
George Cardona admits he paid little attention to his diet before type 2 diabetes caused him to slip into a coma.
Before I knew I had diabetes, I used to eat everything. Whenever I could find pasta.
He was diagnosed 25 years ago, but even today, cases of the disease are growing rapidly due to poor lifestyle choices.
So it's that combination of weight gain and age that is driving this flood.
Across the state, some districts are at more risk. 7.2% of people on the south coast have the condition. At Smithfield in Sydney's southwest, it's 7.1% of the population, but the highest is Mount Druitt at 7.4%. Low-income regions are heavily represented.
Even in suburbs with a high prevalence of diabetes, like here in Western Sydney, experts say personal responsibility plays a role in prevention, but also that governments can do a lot more to help.
Researchers point to Sydney's crippling congestion, time-poor commuters who spend hours in their cars and make easy and quick food choices to compensate.
Public transport and good roads will decrease transit times and give people more time to be physically active.
You have to change the environment around there and the context around the individual, otherwise you're getting nowhere.
It's estimated diabetes costs $3 billion every year and accounts for 12% of all health costs in the country. Josh Murphy, 10 News.